What's up, everybody? Coach Malcolm Mel here. Today we're going to go over the back-to-wall shoulder flexion. So shoulder flexion is the motion your shoulders make when you bring your arms up over your head. But we're going to use a wall to help us make this movement more effective and efficient, so we're using the right muscles. Because believe it or not, we tend to use a lot of wrong muscles to do this motion, and the muscles we use are rather inefficient. So the back-to-wall shoulder flexion helps us, one, test to see how our shoulder flexion is and how good our thoracic, cervical, lumbar alignment and extension is into the shoulder flexion position. But two, it also helps us alleviate the muscles that are overcompensating and growing the muscles that should be working here. So to start, we're going to be against the wall. I like to keep my feet about 6 inches away from the wall, so I have a little bit of space between my feet and the wall. I'm gonna take my butt, bring it to the wall, and then line up my back, everything from my sacrum, lumbar spine, midline, thoracic, cervical, everything, all the way to the top of my forehead is gonna be completely flat against the wall. Now this might make your shoulders round forward. I want you to try to bring your shoulders up and back as much as you can while maintaining that flat back. That's the key here, is a completely flat back, okay? Now, keeping that flat back, we're going to reach out in front of us. And just like you're reaching for something just out of reach, you're gonna keep going all the way up and overhead. And you're gonna keep going overhead until you feel like your back is gonna come off the wall. So I'm at a position where I feel like my back's almost there. I'm gonna try and push all my air out of my diaphragm. And if you touch the wall, you made your marks, and come back down all the way. So common faults in the back-to-wall shoulder flexion is setting up and trying to get our shoulders back, but then actually having a big arch in the mid to lower back here, or starting to do the back-to-wall shoulder flexion and getting about here, and then the midline starts to break. We want to try and keep that core nice and engaged and tight as we move through the back to wall shoulder flexion. Now this motion should go nice and slow all the way up and all the way back down. The back down is just as important on the way up. What we're trying to do here is teach small muscles to move, and larger muscles are overcompensating potentially for that movement. So it's really important you take the time to go slow and really focus on activating all of those muscles in between your shoulder blades as you move up through that motion. All right, I hope that was helpful. Have a good one, everyone.